seriously be in danger now.
Still he goes away, and he really is pouring on the pace. And it's only the clock he's fighting now, and even Juan Torino's world record is in doubt. 1:43.4 to beat. Coe coming up to the finish line, and I think he's got it. 30 yards clear of a world-class field. That's Evans White in second place. White has died trying to chase this young 22-year-old from Loughborough University. Sebastian Coe doesn't know it, but certainly his British record is shattered. And when he hears, it must be confirmation. 1:42.33, a new world record for Great Britain and for Sebastian Coe.
But he's so relaxed that he's coming away all down this field. Now they're waking up in the pack behind, but it's too late, they're forgotten. Coe's got time to look around, the crowd are rising, and the time extremely fast. Very near that world record, 3:49.4 it was, and he's underneath it. It's a new world.
It's allowed him to maintain his gracefully styling
the second gear,
Coe now, 30, 40 metres clear. Belger in second place, Boyce dropping back, and Glenn of Ireland is third. There's the magic figure of Filbert Bailly, 3:32.2, when he won the Commonwealth Games. Coe's still looking so easy. He's got such beautiful poise and balance. He flows over the track. And now again, the crowd cry to help. 60 metres left, and Coe comes home so far in front, the rest don't matter. They're roaring him on, and he's got to be very close. Tremendous run, and he's done it. Coe has smashed the world record. Well, that's unofficial, but there were 30-odd thousand people out there on the track with him. And they
which one is the faster? Ovette in the pulling position coming up to attack. There'll be no waves, I suspect, today to the crowd. And there goes Coe. He's looking for Ovette, wondering where he is. He's right there behind him. And Ovette gathers himself on the near side. Strong on the far side. And could this be Ovette's first defeat? Ovette is in trouble. And Coe gets the revenge he wants. Is Straub, third is over, fourth is Busser, fifth is Fotodala, sixth Plachy, sixth
Marish. Into fourth place, and away goes Sebastian Coe, and it really is overdrive again. He's opened up a massive gap. David Warren fighting in second place, and Cook coming on the inside for third, ahead of the Jamaican. But that, I think, is what the crowd wanted to see. A win for Sebastian Coe.
The champion, and the Swiss Pierre de Lis, and then Bailly. Coe streaks down the back straight. Really is going well. Cram is having a terrific battle. He's trying to get away. And remember the winning time. 3:32.1. But he's got company for the first time. He's got to go away. John Walker, the New Zealander, the giant from New Zealand, finds a little bit more. Comes up to Coe again. And 1:06 is Steve Stott, the fast finishing American, coming into the picture. And it's a really fast. And Coe comes away again. He leaves him for dead. And Stott will be second. What's the clock? 3:31. 3:32.19. He is hundreds of seconds outside it.
Out in front. A tremendous run by the world outdoor record holder. And Coe kicks once more. Where he gets it from, I do not know. But he's far too good for the rest. And Coe wins. And the time, a new
by
Coe won't have it this time. Straight away, Coe responds. On the top bend, and Coe leads. Willie Wall back in second place. Fire is third. And Coe looking for danger. They're there with him. Woolbach hunting him home. And Coe kicks from the front. And it's all over. Coe goes right away and makes the lads look as if they're standing still. Sebastian Coe comes home in front. A photograph for second place, with possibly Woolbach getting it.
1,600 metre record comes up at the end of the back straight. This is really survival now for Coe. Steve Cram in the picture, closing up in third place. A remarkable run by the 20-year-old as they approach the 1,500 metre point. The world record on the left-hand side of the frame, and Coe is feeling this. Well, they didn't stop the clock. They have now. He's outside it. Over 12 records survive. And it looks as if the mile will survive as well. Coe going for home. Coe in second place. Sarge third. Can Coe do it? And he's just done it. Coe second. In third place was Schramm. Fourth was Walker. Five, Bettingoga. Six, Delays. And the news is true. That the world record has been 200 metres, and Coe is anxious. But Voigt is not closing. Can Coe do it? He looks back again. He's tiring. Voigt is closing slightly. Where is the Coe kick? Coe coming away again. 60,000 people on there. Coe's roaring Coe home. He's got a tremendous revival there. And he comes home with a new world record. 3 minutes. 47.3, and the sequence of Coe-Ovet is now back with Coe.
Still Kirov holding the curb, Khalifa second, Coe is third, Hillard of Australia, Oceania four. Five is Robinson now, America moving up on the outside. Coe hits the front now with 250 to go. Europe lead, the Soviet Union second, Africa third, East Germany four, America five, Oceania six. Coe looking very, very easy, watched by his mother, is among the spectators, some 50,000 in the stadium. Coe looking for trouble. The big German's outside him, and how big he looks. Coe looks to his right again, and Robinson comes out with that blistering finish he's got. But he's got nothing to offer as Sebastian Coe goes right away. The world record holder treats them almost with contempt. Coe wins the 800. Robinson second. Dietz left Vargadar third. In fourth place was Hillard of the Oceania side, and fifth, Khalifa of the Sudan.
Fourth, the fastest man in the world this year, Kostka Aptenia, and Coe has made the early strike, and they've gone with it. Coe leads. Gruppers looking very powerful in second place. The anxious look from Coe, and they're waiting to attack. Less than 200 to go, and McGeorge in fourth place going well. And Coe starting to accelerate in front. Kostka in second place. Chris McGeorge of Great Britain is third. And this is where Coe broke last time, but he doesn't appear to be breaking at the moment this time. He is going the way, and he's refound the old form. Sebastian Coe storming home in front for a superb win. Russell's in second place, Elliott third, McGeorge fourth, Mays five, Koskai six, Bravado seven, 143.8. The fastest time in the world.
Between the two, it's going to be Britain 1 and 2, unless somebody cracks hopelessly. And Coe comes away. Graham digs in, but Coe comes away to retain the Olympic title. Sebastian Coe, back at his best, is the Olympic champion again. Graham gets the silver.
Fifth place now, the American. And Abascal trying to squeeze inside Coe. 250 metres left. Coe seems to slow it down very slightly there. 200 to go. And Coe beginning to move. Abascal goes with him. Steve Scott goes third. Buster beaten. Delise is fourth. Can Coe win this from the front? The Olympic bronze medalist chasing. Steve Scott, the American, there as well. Coe looking for danger. And he comes away in majestic style. Running with freedom and complete conviction. Coe wins, Scott second, Delise third, Abascal fourth. And the time, 3:32.4.
And begins his push for victory. And the crowd have seen this so often, and the rest are left struggling in his wake. And he even looks over his shoulder. It's going to be very, very quick. 1:44.33.
Still Brown leading, Droppers second, McKean third, Ostrowski four, Collard five, Cram making his move down the back straight, Coe goes through behind him. And Cram very, very wide, so too is Coe, and McKean bidding for gold. But there goes Cram on the outside with less than 200 left, and Coe follows, and McKean is fighting back. Britain one, two, and three. Cram, McKean, and here comes Coe. A dramatic move on the outside by Sebastian Coe. Can this be his first title? Cram appears to be beaten, and Coe means to make this his. Sebastian Coe wins at last. McKean is second, Cram is third. Gold, silver, and bronze. And Coe has done what he's always wanted to do. He's won the major 800 title.
Coe's got himself back in touch again, remarkably so, but there's no harder way than this. Ovette is in about sixth place. Coe is still third. What effect will that dramatic incident have had? He grits his teeth and goes again. This is the hardest possible way to win, but win he could do here as Horsfield comes up and Coe is going to win in the most dramatic fashion imaginable.
And still Elliott driving into the wind in the back straight. Coe tracks him now as right out of trouble and in the right place. Caldwell third. Chris McGeorge following his famous lap for a teammate. And McGeorge trying to go up on the outside. Graham Williamson in fifth place. 200 metres to go. And that's Caldwell through now with Coe on his shoulder. Big Steve Caldwell, Coe there, controlling the race now from the outside. And kicks hard at the bend very early. And Williamson coming through now. Graham Williamson comes right through from the back. He's very, very strong indeed. McGeorge lost his place, and it's Coe in front of Williamson trying to press him. But Coe comes away with very smooth acceleration indeed. Coe relaxed and easy, comes home in front. Williamson second, McGeorge third. Elliott four, Caldwell five, Aikenbilly six. And the time, an astonishing 1 minute 44.99 on a very windy day indeed.